Good afternoon and welcome to our Lenten devotional. Finally got a little sunshine out today, even though it's a bit chilly. I don't know about you, but I sure wish we had a lot of time to be outside right now. But there are some of you who can't even go outside. You're quarantined in your house and you're not able to be out. So I thought today, when you're stuck in the house, what can you do to make life enjoyable? George Bernard Shaw once said, "Best keep yourself clean and bright, for you are the window through which you see the world." I thought that was pretty accurate. You know, what do you see? You can come out on a day like this and you can see beautiful clouds and beautiful trees and your heart can be full of rejoicing. You could come out the next time and it can be cloudy and maybe you think it's even ugly. I never think the outside's ugly, but it might not feel so good to you. Look around your home. What do you see? Do you just see dishes that aren't done? Do you just see messes that are piled up, laundry that needs to be folded, magazines that haven't been read but still stay in the corner? Or do you see a nice place of refuge, a place to call your own, familiarity that soothes your spirit? Sometimes the way we look at things changes our whole perspective. Right now, what are you seeing outside your window? Are there people near you that are cheerful and walking or out with pets? Or are you in the woods where you can see creation, birds and turkeys and all kinds of fun things? I'd like to challenge us today to think about the gifts that we see around us, whether we're stuck inside or whether we're able to be outside a little bit. And remember that all good things come from God. You know, Daryl and I have a saying each day, we repeat a Bible verse. This is the day God has made, and the other one will say, "Let us rejoice and be glad in it." You know, every time we do that, it changes my perspective, because if I'm not quite happy, then I have to say that part, "Let us rejoice and be glad in it." It makes me think about how good God is to us. As you start looking around you, count your blessings. If you were with us in worship on Sunday, you remember that little Maria in our family time was having a very rough time because she loved staying at home, but she didn't like doing the dishes. And so we suggested to her that she thank God for each dish as she put it in. What are you thankful for today? Let us pray. Loving God, in your great mercy, you've given us so much bounty, and even when it feels like there's scarcity all around us, let us rejoice in the day you have made. Amen. Have a blessed day.